In this episode of Brainiacs, we're starting with artificial intelligence. Someday, your doctor might look like this, but not yet, so don't worry. But researchers at the Center for Data Science and our School of Medicine have created an AI diagnostic tool, and it's helping doctors detect breast cancer with more accuracy. They trained the man-made neural network with more than 1 million mammography images so it could learn what is breast cancer and what isn't. Since mammograms are really high-resolution images, the researchers also taught the AI tool to analyze small patches and then create a map of the areas that are most at risk. The study found that when trained, AI can spot changes that are invisible to the human eye, and overall, it detects breast cancer just as well as an average radiologist. And here's the bonus. The AI tool working together with a human radiologist produced the most accurate results. Now, if you want to give your human brain a little boost, try smashing some avocados. This is one of three mobile app games developed by Steinhardt professor Jan Ploss and his team at the Create Lab. They're all designed to improve executive functions.
Executive functions are a basic cognitive skill that we acquire early on in early childhood. They allow you to regulate your emotions when you feel very strongly about something, to be able to control that.
This guacamole game teaches that inhibitory control. You're supposed to crush the avocados that are basically naked, but not the one with the spiky hats. It's like when you want to yell at your significant other or your roommate, but you learn to resist. Now this game, All You Can Eat, is all about cognitive shifting. That's your brain's ability to adjust your behavior to different situations as they come up. So sometimes these aliens want cupcakes, sometimes they want milk. The rules of the game keep changing, just like the rules of life, and you just gotta roll with it. Now, unlike most so-called brain games, these were actually tested with real people thanks to a grant from the U.S. Department of Education. And the researchers found improvement in executive functions after just 20 minutes of playing. So gamers, play on. Now, speaking of mental boosts, the next time you eat a huge meal and then you find yourself in a little bit of a food coma, you may actually be improving your memory. Researchers at the Center for Neuroscience tested this theory on California sea slugs. Slugs are often used in brain studies because they have really big brain cells and there's not that many, so it's easy to see what's up. Anyway, the scientists fed the slugs some savory seaweed. Eating promotes the release of insulin, a hormone that diminishes movement and increases the absorption of nutrients. That's what leads to the whole rest and digest period, or what you might call a food coma. I think this guy had a little too much espresso. But in the sluggish slugs, the researchers were surprised to see that insulin also strengthened the connections between brain cells, or neurons, which plays a role in long-term memory formation. And while the insulin process is, of course, more complex in humans than in slugs, the authors of the study say it may help explain the biological purpose behind our love of a good post-fiesta siesta. I'm Sapna Parikh. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.